Our next topic is actually a question from one of our viewers. So let's hear her question.
My name is Melissa and I'm from Huntington Beach, California. So here's my question. So my fiance and I have been together for the last 3 years and our relationship has always been great. But the past 3 months, he's been studying to pass the bar. So we haven't really talked that much. Should I address my feelings head on?
Oy, that's a tough one. What do you think, Steve?
Well, I mean, I could just tell you flat out. The guy is focused right now. And it's too... Men are... Look, we're very strange creatures.
Yeah.
You can go in there and bring the subject up.
He's not ready to receive that message.
He ain't, because he... I'm in the middle of
something. Yeah.
What are you talking about? I don't spend time with you. Do you know what I'm trying to do here?
Exactly.
So we can have a better life? That's all you gonna get from
me. Okay, but I disagree with that a little bit because I actually, my parents had the exact same scenario. My dad was in law school. My mom was a teacher. She was paying all the bills. She was making all the food. She was making sure everything was okay. But they were already married. So she knew his studying was for the greater good of the couple.
Mm-hmm.
They're not married yet. So I kind of feel like she should be like, pause. We just need to have a conversation about, are we moving towards our future together? Because if I'm here helping you get through this hard time in your life, am I a sponsor to a greater good in your situation? Or am I riding with you? And if they're not married yet, just do it. Just go to the courthouse so we know that we are in this together and I'm not gonna be out there alone after you pass the bar. I think that's important. I think it's important.
I agree with parts of that, but I also think whether you're engaged or you're married, if you're starting out your relationship and you're not comfortable to share how you're feeling,
you're in
for a lifelong of disappointment with that relationship.
But
I'm not saying you have to change it, but there's a way you can have the conversation without being aggressive, and you can say, listen, can we just do something special this week, just you and I, for 45 minutes?
I was born and my dad was taking the bar. He missed my birth because he was taking a test. Like, it is no joke, that law school.
But if you go into a wedding and you're not feeling any intimacy or you're not feeling that love there, you're not getting married at the right time.
But here's the thing. Here's the thing. She asked a question. She's 3 months into this, so she already knows her answer. You already know. She knows it's been 3 months that it's not the right time. He's not able to receive that kind of message. And at the end of the day, they're going to be married. I mean, they're going to be married in the long... It's a long, long time they're going to be married. And in this situation... Patience is a very specific kind of confidence.
If she's confident in this relationship, that's
what I'm trying to say.
Yeah,
but if she's asking the question, which leads me to believe that
maybe she's not that confident.
We want to believe that love is like a game of tennis.
We do.
You hit the ball and you want a return serve.
Yeah.
Well, guess what? Not every time you're going to get a return serve. And you're going to have to keep hitting balls because that's a loving relationship.
You know what? I think I can see the point. You can't ask a woman not to want reassurance. You can't ask her that. But at the same time, ladies, you can't ask a man to get off his hustle. Because it drives him. You can ask a man to...
You'll lose.
Hey, look, I want to thank you ladies for coming out today, for sharing your opinion. We'll be right back, everybody. Hey, you made it to the end of this video. I got a lot more that you're going to enjoy, so just click to watch the next one. And make sure you subscribe to always know what's happening.